this is an interesting building. And there's more to it than meets the eye, isn't there?
There certainly is. I suspect most people passing by don't look past the Victorian shop front. But behind, this is actually a 17th century half-timbered building.
And look, helpfully, it's dated. Just at the top of this western gable is the date, 1624.
Yeah, and there's an impressive two-story oriel window right below it.
And there are two similar ones on the side wall as well.
The initials refer to William Roberts. That's a link to one of our earlier trails. His grandson built Drybridge House.
Oh, yes. And this site is taking us right back in time, because there was an even earlier house on the site, wasn't there?
Yeah, that's right. It shows clearly on John Speed's 1610 map of Monmouth.
Now, this building has had several uses through the years.
Yeah, for many years it was an ironmonger's. Josiah Coates opened as an ironmonger and blacksmith in 1830.
And the business seems to have stayed in the family, because from the 1860s to 1883, the proprietor was Joseph Coates.
Yeah, and there was still continuity because William Honeyfield took over as an ironmonger here in 1884.
Ah, yes, he was very prominent, wasn't he? Mayor between 1891 and 1895.
Yeah, and there are interesting links to the church as well.
That's right. Joseph Coates was a church warden at St Mary's Priory Church, and William Honeyfield was a member of the Bellring, is there?
There we go.